The Yuri Dolgoruki nuclear submarine, one of Russia's newest on the prowl. Test firing intercontinental ballistic missiles from under the sea, putting America and its allies on notice.
They're letting us know that they're out there. They're operating in much greater numbers in places that they have not operated before.
As tensions between the U.S. and Russia rise, America says it's not overly concerned about Vladimir Putin's fleet of warships, but that the stealthy and powerful subs pose a serious threat to American and allied navies, supply lines, and even ports. America is reacting, sending its most advanced P-8 anti-submarine planes to the Northern Atlantic region and spending $34 million upgrading this base in Iceland, where CNN was given exclusive access.
The ocean is big. It's a chess match between the sub-commander and all the ASW assets that are trying to find him.
Submarines are now one of the centerpieces of Russia's navy, the U.S. says, like the massive Oscar-class, nicknamed the Carrier Killer, because its mission is destroying U.S. aircraft carriers. And the modernized Kilo-class, now capable of carrying cruise missiles. CNN was on hand when Kilos launched several off the coast of Syria, hitting ISIS targets hundreds of miles away. A threat America has to respect and react to, the U.S. top naval commander for Europe and Africa tells CNN.
Where we can no longer take for granted that we can sail with impunity in all of the oceans, whether it be the North Atlantic, the Baltic, the Black Sea, the Mediterranean, or the Arctic Ocean.
The U.S. says it won't be intimidated by Russia's resurgent submarine fleet, but it is rallying allies to get serious about countering Moscow's underwater moves.